Hey guys, I know it's been a while since I've done a makeup video, so I wanted to do this for you guys. So first off, I start by putting oil on my face because I am currently located in Orlando and it's a bit drying for my skin. So I start by putting oil on my skin, and then I have a couple pumps of the Too Faced Born This Way foundation that I use, and that I apply in dots. And I don't have a mirror, like a small one. See, the one I'm using in my hand right now is a small one that I use, but like we have a big mirror and it's just not good for doing makeup. But anyways, yeah, so I apply the makeup in dots, in sections of my face, and then I go on with the bigger side of the beauty blender and blend that all into my skin. Next up, I have my Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer that I use under my eyes. And of course, you want to apply the concealer in a V formation under your eyes. And I kind of do it for a bigger, I make a bigger V now because, you know, dark circles and lack of sleep now that I'm in college. No, I'm just joking. I'm getting sleepy, y'all boys. But yeah, you want to make sure that you apply your concealer in a V-shaped form. And then I go in with a beauty blender and blend that into my foundation and right under my eyes. I'm so sorry for my face of confusion, but next up, I put a little bit of a banana colored powder under my eyes, and usually after I contour, I put a little bit of powder under that, but right now I'm using a big fluffy brush to just use the powder to set my concealer under my eyes. I have like combination dry skin, so I don't really have to do this step, but I like the look that it gives afterwards. I do get oily in my T-zone, so that's where I would put most of the powder as well. But as for under my eyes, I just want to set the concealer, but I don't actually have to do that step considering that my skin is pretty drying already. So and now we are moving on to contouring. Of course, I'm going to take an angled brush and use the medium shade and the darkest shade in the palette to contour my cheeks, my forehead, and my jawline. I kind of pucker my face to get my cheeks part. I move along the side of my face up to my forehead. I learned from a makeup video that I am not actually supposed to contour like all around my forehead, rather just do the sides and avoid the middle, because if I do the middle, it'll make my forehead look bigger, and that's what I don't want. So that's a tip for guys with people with big foreheads like me. I also use the e.l.f. contour kit sometimes if I want my contour to be more defined, because the kit I was using before, the Perfusion one, is very well loved. I'm looking to find another one, but I'm not entirely sure that they still sell those, but hopefully, guys, I can find another kit just like this. But the e.l.f. contour kit works equally as fine, and it's really inexpensive. I think I spent like $3 on it at Target. So definitely, if you're looking for some cheap drugstore makeup, definitely recommend the e.l.f. contour palette. I forgot to mention, I also use more of the medium and a little bit of the darkest shade in the palette to contour my nose. I go along the sides and almost move down in the V format because I have a Borbis nose, I think that's what it's called, and you want to, if you want to slim it down, you want to focus on the V part of your nose to make it look slimmer, the illusion of that. So yeah, that's how I contour my nose. I also go back into the e.l.f. palette to make the contour more defined. And like I said earlier, right after contouring, I'm going to go back in with the banana powder right under where I contoured to just make it sharper and more defined. And I go in with the Beauty Blender. Sometimes I use a brush. This day particular, I use a Beauty Blender. Don't know why I did that. But most of the time, I use a big fluffy brush like the one I used earlier to set the powder under my eyes. The next step that I did, once again, is use the banana powder and apply it along the sides of my nose to define and sharpen the contour that I applied earlier. Next up, I'm taking my favorite Morphe palette, the 35A Dare to Create palette, and I always start off with an orange transition color on the base of my lids and on the crease. And today I was going for a golden look, so I used more of a bronze transition color. And I actually don't have the names because they're on that plastic thing that you get on these kind of palettes, so I really couldn't tell you the name, but it's that shade right there that I start off with as the base. I apply this shadow using a big fluffy brush from my Provision kit, and I just apply this shadow to both of my eyes in a windshield circling movement. Next, I take my Wet n Wild flat brush and I will be applying a golden shade, that one right there, I believe that one is called Artistic, to the base of my eyelids. Also, I have gone in with a brown on the outer V of my eyes, and now I am just lining up the base of my eyelids with Artistic. Again, I go back in with the flat-ended brush into Artistic and go over for a second base coating over the lid of my eyes to intensify the color more. I have applied eyeliner and a little bit of glitter from this glitter palette that I got from Five and Below. Because I can't do eyeliner on camera, apparently. So now I'm going to be applying mascara with my Maybelline. I don't remember the name of this mascara. But yeah, I'm going to apply that on. And then falsies also off camera because I can't do that on camera either. The eyeliner I use, by the way, is the Tartist one. It has a liquid end and a pencil end. And then I use the liquid, obviously, for my lids, and then the pencil side for my waterline. After applying 2 coats of mascara to my eyelids, once again, I am going to be using falsies. My falsies happen to be on my compact mirror because I'm ratchet. And there we have it, folks. Falsies. They make everything look so much better. So now I'm going to use my Mario Tabasco spray. I already forgot the name, but I spray that all over my face, you know, just to rejuvenate my skin, make it look more alive, because like I said earlier, I have combination dry skin and I don't want it looking too dry. And next I'll be applying highlighter, my Milani highlight palette. I use the lightest shade typically under my brow and the medium shade for the top of my cheeks. After applying the highlight, my favorite part of my makeup routine, it is now time to do the brows. And after doing my brows, I apply a little bit of highlight right underneath the brow bone. And a little bit of highlight will be going on my nose at the tip and on the bridge, kind of like an exclamation point. I go in after applying my highlight and pat it in with my fingers so that it is not too much and you can't really tell where the line of the highlight starts and stops. And then I'll be taking my Mario Tabasco spray again, spraying my face one more time, once again to rejuvenate my face. And now we are finished. This is my completed look. And the next clip I'll be showing you a closer up of what my eyes look like so you guys can see that. Alright guys, that is the completed makeup look. Not gonna lie, I was feeling myself a little bit. It looks really nice. Came out really great. That was my outfit for the night. I went out. And thank you guys for watching this makeup get ready with me. See you guys next time.